Last weekend, we picked up a new engine for the C10 build because I had a change of plans, but I explained it all in that video. Due to that, that's how we ended up here. Got a broken stud right there, one this side, one right there, and then one right there on the manifold.
I'm pretty sure when we go to taking this fully apart, we're probably gonna break some more. So I'm gonna do a video showing you how to get those out. I decided to pick up the camera and share this with you guys because I did mention in the previous video when we picked up this engine that I would share this with you guys. So in this one, we are gonna show you how to extract a broken bolt. So we have three broken bolts that are broken off into the head where the manifold is bolted in. We're gonna show you a little trick or technique, whatever you wanna call it, on how to get that bolt out. It could be a broken bolt anywhere. I mean, this technique works for anything. And if you haven't been on the channel in a while or you're new to the channel, you probably wonder why we have two engines sitting here. We originally picked up this 350 to go into the C10, but we had a little bit of change of plans. So we're gonna go with this. And if you have no clue, and this is your first time on the channel, we have the 68 Camaro that's over there.
This is Alice F350. We've got the 500 in the car trailer. And here's the C10. This is the project truck of the channel. We have an entire playlist of this entire build from when we first got it up until now.
The engine that we're gonna be extracting these bolts out of is a 5.3 LS, and that's gonna eventually go into the C10. And hopefully this video can help someone. I don't know. Hopefully it helps somebody. Let's get to the video. We got Clay back in the garage doing some work.
Always in the driver's seat.
We're gonna do in this video, I put some, what is that? Aerocroil? I don't know how you say that, but anyway, if you hear a bunch of noise in the background, the kids are over here on the power wheel. We've got a broken bolt there. I think we got another one on that end. So we got some broken bolts, so we're trying to remove this manifold. So we're gonna just take the manifold off, and then we'll show you guys the broken bolt. Yeah, so all of these are actually coming out pretty soon.
Just that one.
This is the kit. I guess we're gonna start drilling a hole in the block, and he's missing the one that we need. That's the one we need.
These are actually an Irwin.
First thing we're gonna do is
mark the center of the bolt. It actually has a center punch on it.
Try to get the thing as close to center as possible.
There we go. All that noise, because you know, this is shop. We got Liam over there working on his race car over there. Now,
so it actually tells you what size drill bit to use. This one's a 532.
532nd?
Or 532nd.
That's what we got in there, is a 532nd. So we're basically gonna drill the hole, get that started. This essentially is pretty much threaded backwards. So when you thread it in there counterclockwise. So as you're going in like this, it's digging into it and biting it, and then at the same time it's backing the bolt out. It's kind of weird how it works, but it works. So let's do this. Did I explain that proper?
Yeah.
All right. It's kind of weird.
It's hard to explain, but once you
once you actually do it. So we're gonna thread, or we're gonna drill that in to start it. All right, yeah, so we just stuffed the exhaust port with that rag just to keep metal from getting in there. We're gonna drill this out.
And you don't want to drill it out completely. You just want to drill it out just enough to where the easy out will bite into it. Yep, just like that.
And this right here is the technique. Where's that wrench?
Set your wrench on here like this. Take your hammer and you're gonna tap on it.
So pretty much put the hammer on there, tap and back out, tap and back out.
Thank you.
there you go. That's pretty much how to get a bolt, a broken bolt. I mean, that could be any type of bolt. Especially bolts, when they break off in your block, it can become very, very scary. But if you just take your time with it, you can pretty much do it. And there's what this kit looks like. We're by far not sponsored by this, but it definitely works. This is the kit that we just used, just in case any of you guys are interested in. This is Clay's kit. Best believe I will be investing in one of these.
It's like 100 years old.
You got that at the flea market?
Flea market special.
Did you really?
Yeah.
We've had three broken bolts. We got one out already. We just got that one out, which you guys just watched that. So we got one more. Squeeze it. You got to go clockwise this time. There you go. It comes right out so easy. Doesn't even look like we used it. Still looks perfect. Look at this one. This one just came out with your fingers.
Yeah, there's quite a bit of threads on there.
Yep. That one came out nice. So there we go. We had three broken bolts all completely out. We're going to put aftermarket headers, and then when we put the new header bolts in there, we're going to put anti-seize and stuff like that, just to, you know, eliminate this issue again. All we got to do is just prep her and get her ready for install. I need to get engine mounts. I'm gonna order a new wiring harness. I'm giving Clay that wiring harness
for parts.
For parts, yeah. And then because he does a lot of this type of work on the side, so he could probably definitely use it.
Yeah.
And
the sensors on the things actually come in pretty handy.
What would you recommend doing to this engine?
Before we put it in?
Yeah.
New main bearings and rod bearings.
All right.
And head gaskets.
So.
Nasty cam.
Nasty cam?
Yep.
We might have to. We might. Better get on the interweb and start ordering some parts. Hey, hon.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you a Christmas list here soon, all right? You ready for your Christmas list?
No.
No?
I have crackers and bars if you want some, Clay.
Oh, no, I'm fine.
You know she didn't offer me any?
It's because she likes me better.
Whatever. But look at that baby bump. Look at that. Saw that bear. We got a few more things to do to this thing before we drop it in the C10. I want to get new plugs too. That's actually what we're doing on the Camaro right now, is putting new plugs in it because she's missing. And we're going to see how that cleans it up a little bit.
Show me the plug.
Yeah, that's a plug that we just pulled out. Yeah, we're going to put new ones in there. Yeah, this was basically just a cool little quick vlog I thought I could share with you guys, just show you guys a quick little trick on how to get a bolt out. Maybe it can help someone, I don't know. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead, get ready, and wrap this video up. But let us know in the comments if you guys have any tricks or how you would extract a broken bolt, or let us know like what we did wrong, because I'm sure there's always somebody in the comment section like, what did you do wrong? Because if you notice in the video when we went to drill, I was like, Clay, hold on, stop, we need to put a rag in the exhaust port. Here, let me get a shop rag. And he's like, nah, we're good. And I'm like, nah, if we don't, you know. But anyways, I'm gonna go ahead, wrap this video up. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget, hit the subscribe button, and I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.